In this video, I'm going to show you a systematic way of factoring basic trinomials that are in this form, x squared plus bx plus c. So for instance, I have four different basic trinomials, and we'll be factoring all four of those in this video. Notice that means the coefficient of the x squared or the n squared term, etc., is 1. And then there may or may not be a coefficient you see in front of x. We didn't do one like that, but you might also have something like x squared plus x minus 2, and there is a coefficient of x, and it's 1. So in this case, b would be 1. Okay, so although we don't do that one in this video, that's a possibility. Now, there are several ways and methods people use to factor basic trinomials. One is the trial error method, and I won't be covering that in this video. I'm going to use a systematic approach using the product and sum idea. The first thing you would want to note is in order to get an x squared for the first term, if I were to break this up into two binomials, the first term in each parentheses would have to be an x to get an x squared, and that would work all the way. Whoops, that would be an n, of course, because it's an n squared, etc. And what we're going to do in this video is figure out what the binomial is in here. So we know it starts with x, but what's the second part of it? Is it x plus 4 times x minus 1, or x minus 4 times x minus 1, etc.? And we're going to be using the product and sum idea to get that. One of the things we're going to be noticing is whatever I do put in here, when I multiply them together, these two numbers, whatever I end up putting here, have to multiply out to be 4, because that would come from the last term. And these two numbers here, when I multiply them together, would have to give negative 36. Well, there are a lot of different possibilities for numbers that multiply out to be negative 36, correct? So our trick is, what two numbers are we going to put in there? And it's going to be based on this middle term. The sum has to come from the outer and the inner term. So when I do add the inner and outer term, I'm going to have to get a positive 5. So we're going to be looking for numbers for the second one, for instance, where the product is negative 36 and the sum is 5. So that's what we're going to work on. Okay, so we're going to start off with, well, I do know the only way to get an x squared is if there was an x in each of these. Now we're going to do this product sum thing. Here's the trick. The two numbers here have to have a product of that last term, which is 4. So I want two numbers where the product is 4, but I want to make sure when I add the inner term and the outer term together, I get a negative 5. So the sum is going to be negative 5. All right, so we want numbers that have a product of 4. Well, 1 times 4 and 2 times 2, that's it. If the sum is negative, the negative goes in front of the bigger number. So we know that the negative sign goes there. And since the product is positive, they have to have the same sign. So when you multiply them, you get a positive. Then you see which one has the correct sum. There it is. So this is minus 1 and minus 4, and there you go. So it's just a little bit more systematic way of doing it using the product and sum ideas. Okay, so here's another one. Factor m squared plus 9m plus 20. Well, we know that we're going to have m and m. So then we look for the product and sum. I'm going to move this over a little bit. Okay, so our product, these two terms here, are going to have to multiply out to be 20, that last term. And the sum is going to be 9. So let's just list the product, the two numbers that multiply out to be 20. 1 and 20, 2 and 10, 3 doesn't go into it, and then 4 and 5. Now the sum's positive, so the bigger number is positive, and the product's also positive, so everything's positive here. So then we see which one has the correct sum of 9, 4, and 5. And that's it. And you should always check by doing the FOIL method or getting out and doing the box method. All right, let's do another one. All right, x squared plus 5x minus 36. So I want you to write over here, what's the product and what's the sum? Be careful. The product is the last number over here, the negative 36. The sum is positive 5. So there's actually a lot of numbers that multiply out to be 36. 1 and 36, 2 and 18, 3 and 12, 4 and 9, and 6 and 6. Quite a lot. Now, the sum's positive, so the bigger number has to be positive. So I've already got them being positive. I don't have room to put my little plus sign. But when I multiply them, they've got to be negative. So this smaller number over here is going to have to be negative. All right? I'm going to have to be opposite signs to get a product of negative 36. So which one gives me that sum of positive 5? There it is. So we've got x minus 4 and x plus 9. Well, some people might just look right at that x squared plus 5x minus 36 and you sort of see what it's going to have to be, x minus 4 and x plus 9. That's great. In fact, that's how I do it because I didn't learn this systematic method when I took algebra. So I just had to, you know, plow through and hopefully eventually get the right answer. All right, so let's try another one. Okay, so try this one. Put it on pause, try it, and then come back. Okay, the product is going to be 75. The sum is going to be negative 20. So make sure you really list all the numbers that multiply out to be 75. 1 goes into it, 2 goes into it, 3, 4 does not, 5 does. Here's the easy way. Remember, 5 goes into 25, 5 times the 3 is 15. Or you could take your calculator and do 5 into 75. Let's see, 6 doesn't go into it, 7 doesn't go into it, 8 doesn't go into it, 9, well, 9 squared is already bigger than 75. So this is it. Sum is negative, so that goes in front of the larger number. And since the product is positive, then both numbers have to be negative. All right, so what gives us our correct combination? N minus 5 and N minus 15. And again, I'm not showing the check, but you would definitely want to check this by multiplying back out. All right, let's do one more. Yeah, this is kind of a pain because it's got a big number, negative 180. You've got to write all the factors of negative 180. So let's do that. The product is going to have to be negative 180. Okay, you're just going to have to deal with that. So 1 and 180, 2 goes into it, 90. 3, 60, and even if you have a calculator, you can go ahead and get out a calculator if you're allowed to use one. Let's see, does 4 go into it? Well, 4 goes into 60, 15, so it's going to be 4 and 45. Let's see, 5. Well, 5 goes into 45, 9 times 4 is 36. 6 goes into 36, 6 times 5 is 30. 7 doesn't go into any of these numbers. 8 does not go into any of those numbers. 9 does not go into any of those numbers. 10, yeah, 10 goes into 180. 10 times 18. And 11 does not. Does 12 go into any of these numbers? Yes, it does. Don't assume it does not. 12 goes into, I looked over here, 12 goes into 36. 3 times 5 is 15. 13 and 14 don't, and I'm done. Whew! Okay, now, the sum is negative, so the bigger number is negative. And the product is negative, so the other number has to be positive. Okay, which combination adds up to negative 3? There it is. Don't give up. A lot of people won't list them all, and they just assume it can't be factored. This definitely does factor, and there it is.